Hey future nurses, if you want to ace the NCLEX, you need to know UTIs inside and out. They're the most common infection in women, and trust me, the test loves this topic. So let's break down the secrets, anatomy, symptoms, and my killer study hacks. First, what's a UTI? It's an infection anywhere along your urinary tract. Picture this, kidneys up top, ureters as the tubes, bladder as the holding tank, and the urethra as the final exit. Bacteria, usually E. coli from the GI tract, make their sneaky move from back to front, straight into the urinary system. If you find more than 100,000 bacteria per milliliter, boom, that's clinically significant. Now, let's talk UTI types. Uncomplicated UTIs are usually in healthy women, mainly just the bladder, and there's no weird anatomy or instruments involved. But if you've got catheters, kidney stones, diabetes, pregnancy, or a neuro disorder, that's complicated. The infection can climb up to the kidneys and it's harder to treat. NCLEX tip. Uncomplicated usually means cystitis. Complicated? Watch for resistance and recurrence. Red flag time. Urosepsis. If that UTI spreads to the bloodstream, it's life-threatening. Look for low blood pressure, fast heart rate, fever, and confusion, especially in older adults. This is an emergency, so don't miss it. Diagnosis is all about the right test at the right time. Start with a dipstick. It checks for nitrites, white cells, and leukocyte esterase. Nitrites, think E. coli. Next, follow up with a full urinalysis, and always get a clean catch midstream sample before starting antibiotics. For recurrent or complicated cases, do a urine culture. Over 100,000 CFU is your number. Pro tip for the NCLEX. Teach patients the right way to collect a sample. Females wipe front to back. Males clean the tip and catch midstream. Simple, but so high yield. Treatment? For uncomplicated UTI, think Bactrim, unless there's a sulfa allergy, or Nitrofurantoin for bladder infections. But don't use Nitrofurantoin for kidney infections, or if kidney function is bad. And here's the catch. Don't treat asymptomatic bacteriuria unless the patient is pregnant. Let's talk defense. Healthy urine is acidic, packed with urea, and has proteins that keep bacteria from sticking. If urine turns alkaline, maybe from antacids, risk goes up. Older adults? They're tricky. Forget the classic burning when peeing. Instead, watch for confusion, vague belly pain, or even new onset delirium. If grandma's acting weird, always consider a UTI. Symptoms split into two tracts. Lower tract, bladder, means burning, urgency, frequency, and maybe cloudy or bloody pee. Upper tract, kidneys, brings flank pain, fever, chills, nausea, and tenderness over the back. How can you prevent UTIs? Drink lots of fluids, void regularly, wipe front to back, go before and after sex, and skip the bubble baths and harsh soaps. Avoid caffeine, spicy foods, chocolate, citrus, and alcohol. They all irritate the bladder. And a heating pad to the lower belly? That's pure comfort. Here's what trips up students. Clean catch does not need antiseptic wipes, just moist gauze. Dipstick is the first test, not urinalysis. Hematuria doesn't rule out UTI, and Nitrofurantoin is for the bladder only, not the kidneys. Mega quick facts, E. coli is king. Women get UTIs way more than men, and hospital-acquired UTIs are super common. In older adults, delirium might be your only clue. Urosepsis is always an emergency, and that midstream technique, it's critical. That's your UTI crash course for the NCLEX. Focus on the anatomy, know your symptoms, and remember these hacks. You've got this.